Specific head-on collision, the names of the people involved have been released, including the name of 19-year-old Matt Adams, a Marine from Camp Pendleton who had just been home to Utah to see his girlfriend and family.
Like, literally just the other day, he was able to get leave for 15 days after Christmas. He was home for the new year. We were able to do a lot of the things that he had wanted to do. Got to go shooting, camping, hang out with his family and his friends.
We're pretty upset on this end about at this gentleman. As everyone has the questions, why? It just makes no sense to us.
Matt's older brother, John, says Matt's been stationed here in San Diego for about 2 years and absolutely loved being in the Marines.
That really appealed to him, at least to my knowledge it did. And he loved it.
For as much as he blended in with the crowd, he stuck out like a sore thumb. It was like, there's something about this kid I just gotta know. And
his girlfriend, Raiden Lynn, says she dropped him off at the airport in Salt Lake Monday night.
Got on the plane, got a message that he had landed and never heard that he had made it back to base. And that's when he had two military men dressed down at the front door.
Matt was killed on I-5, likely heading home from the airport. Highway Patrol says 42-year-old Christian Zarita was driving the wrong way on I-5, trying to get away from police when he slammed into Matt's car. Both drivers died. Looking at Zarita's arrest history, he's had multiple arrests, including one back in 2010. Prison records say he attempted to evade officers with reckless driving. The report says he drove with willful and wanton disregard for safety of persons and property. We did try reaching out to the family of Christian Zarita here Wednesday afternoon, called two numbers, knocked on three doors associated with the family's contact information. So far, we haven't heard back. From Chula Vista, Jeff McKinney.